It's a beautiful afternoon here in Ohio. There's my front yard. These are the stairs to my driveway out to the road. That tree there is going to be one of the supports to a large loop, and these trees will also be supports for the large loop. But in the meantime, what I'm using is this antenna that I've just got temporarily off the ground, barely, but it's an inverted V. Pretty funny, but that's because the center point's not on support, and it's heavier than the wire, so it drapes down below and fed with 50 ohm coax temporarily being run. Taking a closer look at the antenna, that's the feed line going into a ballon, balanced, unbalanced transformer. It's a current ballon. Temporary, again, I have nothing supporting it. But I'm going to change this to a 1-to-1 ballon, current ballon. It has this 4-to-1 after I do some work on the housing. It's an MFJ, pretty poorly housed. They've got drain holes, but the thing fills up with moisture way too quickly because there's no sealing whatsoever around the ends there. Anyway, I'm going to redo that for the loop, the 160 meter full wavelength horizontal loop that I'm building. So that's going to be repurposed for that. I've got a 1-to-1 ball in coming, and this antenna will be fed with that. And right now it's cut for 40 meters, going up to a pulley there. Now that tree, once I get the supports higher, will probably be the center point for this dipole. And then that's the antenna that will become a general purpose DXing antenna. Now, let me show you how low this antenna really is. Okay, there's the garage, first floor. And you can see my house is on a hill a bit. So the tree is, it's up there a bit, so the one end's up a little bit, but not by much. But the center is not even a full, not even a story high. And the other end just goes to the top of the second story porch roof there. That tree will be a support at some point for that, probably for one of the ends of the antennas, and I'll string it across to that tree. But I have reached Belgium and France and whatnot on 20 meters with this antenna, and I've done California, Washington State, CW and whatnot with the antenna right as it is, which goes to show you, if you get something in the air, it's likely to work a little bit, maybe adequately. So don't fret it. Get an antenna on the air and get on the air. Get your station on the air. It doesn't take much. And so this is the result. Looking at 7 megahertz up to 7.068, and it is 2210 UTC, 2211 UTC as I'm filming this part. And there's plenty of signals. Now, I probably am not hearing every possible thing I could hear if the antenna was up in the air, but not bad.